Hey everybody. So Meta released a new research paper yesterday. I think that this is going to be likely the last research paper from Meta and Yann LeCun specifically, and it's called "Learning Latent Action World Models in the World," printed on January 8, 2026. Up front, I think you're probably going to hear a lot about this research paper, I would imagine, right? Because it comes from Meta. If you hear anyone praising this research paper, flat out, that person does not know what they're talking about. Like, I cannot make it more simplistic than that. I don't care that it's Yann LeCun. I don't care that it's Facebook. I don't care that it's Meta, whatever, right? If they are praising this, they do not know what they're talking about within this, and they are literally just propagating this research paper only because it's Meta and the name Yann LeCun on it. And that is how the world works overall, right? Like, I can't stress that enough to people. Like, that is blatantly just how the world works. Like, all Meta has to do is put out a research paper and say world models and to talk about world models and then talk about this concept for what has been 2 years now, just talking about this concept, and the world is enamored by world models. Like, people could go out and get funding for world models just because Yann LeCun and Meta has talked about it overall for the last 2 years, right? But within this, and then as you per usual within these things, this particular research paper from Meta is all talk. Not a singular line of code is in this research paper. Not a singular actual theorem or theory is in this research paper, right? Like, there's no like provable theorem within this research paper. There's no workable model. Their specs on their models suck. Their benchmarks that they release suck. There's a reason why this model and framework is talked about within this and hasn't been discussed. So the predictions here, like, this is a perfect example, right? Look at this context and this first transfer, and then these predictions, like with the ball, where the ball just disappears. That's the majority of my experiments with this framework overall, and why they haven't actually released anything around this framework is the bottom line within this. Like, I cannot stress that enough within this. And at this point, I've dissected to me exactly why this framework fails overall. I think that at this point, Meta has to know these things. And there's a reason why you've never seen a world model in the wild, right? That's like still to this day, Meta does not release these models. Why? Because they don't work. And then, so why don't they work? They don't work very simplistically, right? So these models rely on a philosophical assumption, which is that, so the philosophical assumption in order for these models to work would be that learning can take place without any other priors, meaning that you can just place an entity into a world and it would just learn. But like, human existence disproves that, right? Like, as so if you put a I'll just like there's been like you know like the few times where it has happened in experimental senses and can be documented, things like that, where humans have like a not had the ability to learn like language up front or things like that. They never learn it. Like, there's windows and mechanisms that are designed within the brain, constraints that are designed within the brain at specific times that are facilitate that specific learning, and then constraints at those specific times facilitating learning are the most important part that world models leave out, right? World models are built on no constraints, is essentially like what the bottom line is of them. And then, so I'll do something 100% different within this particular video than I do within normal videos. So normally within a video, like, I'll show you this one notebook when we get to the end here, which would be V5 in this instance of the notebook. And I'd be like, okay, here's the notebook. Here's the results overall of these notebooks. And you would see that this is V5 of the notebook overall. But what you would not see within that is we go here, open notebook, And then so it's V5, V4, V3, V3, V2, and then the initial one. I'm going to give you access to every single one of these, right? Because every single one of these work overall, and they produce a result. They just don't produce a learning result. Like the model doesn't work overall. And I iterate off of this, utilizing essentially everything that I can find about world models overall, the math behind them, etc. Re-engineering. It's not hard to re-engineer the framework at this point of world models exactly as they are expressed within the research, because there's enough research papers around them at this point to reconstruct them. So I've done it in six different ways overall. And every single one of those ways produces the exact same result. So what could disprove anything? Like, it's like Meta could disprove and make me like poo-poo on me tomorrow by releasing a working world model under this framework that works exactly as they state within this research paper. And I would have absolutely no leg to stand on within this. So there it is, right? They could do that. And that would be a good way to essentially counter this overall. But outside of this, what I'm telling you is that there is literally, it's literally impossible for this framework to work overall, is what I've found experimentally within it. And then I've taken this to the next step within this, right? Which is, so I take these frameworks that don't work, and then they don't work because of essentially that base assumption within it, right? That you need some sort of structure. And I won't call it symbols, right? The models don't need symbols, but they need structure. And there's a difference, there's a semantic difference between structure and symbols. If you want to make that semantic difference, and a symbol is can be structure, but structure is what the requirement is, right? Like the model needs a way. So if you're learning a concept, if you're presented with a concept for the first time, you need to have some sort of structure to decide like what exists now prior to what previously existed. And then that structure is in and of itself time, right? That structure, structure is built into everything. Like that's like the reason why humans default to symbols and symbolic learning overall is because it's a very efficient structural system in order to architect the brain and to architect communication, right? It's such a structured system that I can utilize this own structure for me individually, and you can understand it and decode my individual structure. That's pretty unique, right? Like that's hard to do overall, and then symbols allow us to do it. But there's other structures, far other structures, lots of other structures that exist beyond symbols, and other ways to learn beyond symbols. But they all involve some sort of structure. Like there's no way to learn with zero structure overall, and that's like the math that the world models operate under, right? And that's the knock that I have with the world model architecture as a whole, and why it will never work flat out, is because essentially there's zero structure that is involved. So essentially in every single one of these tests, if you go through, if you know what these numbers mean, right? Because it's a bunch of, I assume to a lot of people, gibberish numbers at the end here as to like what these results are. But it's always the same gibberish numbers overall, and the same pattern of these gibberish numbers, if you know how to read them, which is that the model just defaults to doing nothing. I went through this six times, right? And I was like, the model's just broken. Like it's just doing nothing. But the model learns to do nothing because that's the only thing that it can pull structure from when you give it like no structure whatsoever. What does it realize? If there's literally no structure around me whatsoever, the optimal path is nothing. So there's another answer. There's a philosophical answer for you, but that philosophical answer proves that these models won't work because of that. The papers overall, they call it leakage, right? Like the models, there's a leakage that they happens within the learning process overall when they try to do this. It's yeah, because the model is just like going towards whatever is the most optimal pattern, which is when there's no structure whatsoever, zero structure, the optimal pattern is do nothing. And then so that's not leakage, that's the optimal pattern of nothing. And then so makes sense overall to me. And then so if you're trying to optimize towards that, you're gonna have a bad time overall. And then none of the math that you can ever do within these world models gets around that overall, which is why you will never see a world model in the wild. And the only reason overall that we talk about this research paper is because it's put out by these names here. Again, like they don't put out any sort of like, if I had put out this like just this research paper, I'd have like 100 people like calling me garbage, right? Like this dude didn't even like put out the model himself, like blah blah blah, right? And I'm just a YouTube channel, but Meta does it, and then and Jan LeCun, and I guarantee you there's going to be 200 videos on this by tomorrow praising this, right? Every single one of those people, just remember, I guarantee you none of them have actually seen a world model. I would love to see videos, and I guarantee there's going to be people talking about all these world models are so amazing and benchmark tests, blah blah blah, or in this comparison test, where'd you get that model from, bro? They haven't released one still to this day. They haven't actually released the model. They haven't released any of the code. There's nothing related to any of this. It's literally just Meta releasing a press release, and then but Meta can like raise money off of releasing a press release. Like that's how the world works overall. Why does that work? I don't know. I didn't do it. That's how it is, right? There you go. That's how these things work overall. I'll leave a link again to every single iteration of these notebooks here for you. Go crack at them. Feel free. Try to prove me wrong. Like that. Like if this again. Like the claim is that these models will not work with as they're intended within this research paper, which is you're implementing zero structure, just the latent space itself, just the latent operations. It can learn just off of the latent. Like Jan LeCun is. I agree with Jan LeCun like 90%, right? Because like this is based off of like I should love this research paper, right? Because it's based off of like latent learning, all of that, etc. The thing is like they're taking it to the extreme. Like they're like, whoa, bro, like you can't just have 100% out there latent learning. Like you need structure. You need like at least 1%. It's like the other way. Like my philosophy is always like AI works because it's you need nine, like you can have it both ways, right? You could have 99% probabilistic and 1% deterministic, or 1% probabilistic and 99% deterministic, but you always need that blend, right? You can't go 100% deterministic, it doesn't work, and you can't go 100% probabilistic and it doesn't work. And like this is 100% probabilistic, and like attempting to get that to work, it will never work. It's a pipe dream. There's a reason why there's never been models out around it, but because for some reason, this big, huge company keeps putting out research papers, but no models, no code, no etc. around it, we have to keep talking about it. And then so here we are. There it is. If you like this type of content, please like and subscribe. Thank you very much.